Hello friends. Welcome to your favorite YouTube channel Material Welding. This training video explain in detail and provide detailed learning on welding symbols according to latest AWS A2.4 edition. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet to get regular updates on new videos and support my work.
You will observe many different types of welding symbols on the fabrication drawing, such as fillet weld, butt weld, or corner weld, etc. Let's watch and learn this interactive training video to make you expert in welding symbols today.
There is always confusion between weld symbol and welding symbol. A welding symbol is a representation of the specifications for producing a welded joint. For example, this picture here shows the welding symbol of an intermittent fillet weld of 5 mm throat size or 7 mm leg length. And a weld symbol as a graphical character connected to the reference line of a welding symbol specifying the joint geometry of weld type. For example, a fillet weld or bevel or square or flare weld. In this welding symbol here, the triangle represents the weld symbol. So weld symbol as a part of the welding symbol. Here the complete set of primary welding symbols according to AWS A2.4 2020 edition are shown. Please have a look to see each and every type of welding symbol. These symbols shall be drawn in contact with the reference line. Next, here the full supplementary weld symbols are shown. These symbols are called supplementary as they are placed on the primary symbols or supplement the primary weld symbols. For example, all around weld, field weld, backing, weld profile symbol, etc. These symbols to be used in connection with primary welding symbols to provide additional weld joint requirements.
Next, let us learn how a welding symbol is drawn on the drawing. And what are the different parts of the welding symbols and their purposes? A welding symbol consists of several elements. Here, horizontal reference line, arrow line, and weld symbol are the mandatory elements. The horizontal line is called the reference line and is the main part of the welding symbol. The reference line is a mandatory part of the welding symbol, as weld symbols are placed on the reference line. The arrow line connects with the reference line. The arrow of this completed welding symbol points to a location or area to be welded. The weld symbol is placed on the reference line. A weld symbol placed below the reference line means weld is on the arrow side. Similarly, the weld symbol placed above the arrow line means the weld will be made on the opposite side of the arrow. Next is weld size, which is given on the right side of the welding symbol. In the US or related construction, sizes are normally given in inches, while in ISO construction, sizes are specified in millimeter. Weld length, if applicable, is given on the right side of the welding symbol. In case there is no size given on the welding symbol, it's mean welding has to be made on full length. Weld pitch is given after the weld length, if applicable. Weld pitch means center-to-center distance between intermittent welds. Weld length and weld pitch are normally applied to intermittent fillet welds. Example, when welding sheet metals. To brief, weld size always is given on the right-hand side of the welding symbol, while weld length and pitch are given on the right-hand side of the welding symbol. Examples are concave weld, convex weld, or flat weld. So basically they show the final surface requirements for the weld. Next, weld around symbol is used where welding has to be made all around the joint. For example, full welding of a pipe placed vertically on the plate. The field weld symbol is used where welding has to be made at the site, for example, joining big pipe spools at the field instead of welding at the fabrication shop. Due to difficulty in shifting of long lengths to the site. The tail part of the welding symbol provides additional information for the welding. such as welding process to be used, specific materials, or any special process, etc.
Before we will learn the application of welding symbols, let's learn the importance of the arrow side and other side of the welding joint. When the weld symbol is placed below the reference line, the welding will be on the arrow side. Similarly, when the weld symbol is placed above the reference line, the welding will be on the other side as shown in this example here. Next, when the weld symbol is placed on both side of the reference line, it means welding shall be done on both side of the joint as shown here. When all around symbol is given on the welding symbol, it means welding has to be made all around the weld joint as shown here. Now let's understand the symmetrical and non-symmetrical welding symbol. When the welding joint are having the same weld joint preparation on both sides, the symmetrical welding symbol is used as shown here. Example is both side V-groove, both side fillet weld, etc. For welding joint having dissimilar weld joint preparation, non-asymmetrical welding symbols are used. Example is one side single bevel and other side square weld as shown in the picture here. We have already learned the welding symbol for the fillet welds. So now let's see welding symbols for different types of groove welds. The first is square butt weld, which is butt weld without any groove preparation. A second is a single V butt weld and the third is a single bevel butt weld. The last one is a single V with a broad root face, which is also called partial joint penetration weld. Moving next are single bevel butt weld with broad root face, single U butt weld, single J butt weld, and fillet weld types. The picture here shows the various types of welding symbols which are used mostly. Take your time to get familiar with each type. The second picture here shows how the welding joint will look like for each welding symbol. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and get updates on the next part as well as new upcoming videos. Also, please like and share this video so everyone will be benefited from this learning video. Next, let us learn how to read the welding size from a given welding symbol. First, let us see for fillet weld. As we learned earlier, weld sizes are always given on the left-hand side of the weld symbol. So here, 3x8 inches is the size of the fillet weld in the first picture. In the second picture, the weld size is 1x8 inch. When the size is given in this type of dimension, usually they are always in inches. But we must check the unit of dimension given in the fabrication drawing. Moving further, let's learn now reading weld size in groove welds. Here an example of a single V weld is shown. As we see on the left side, the groove size is 20 mm. Inside the weld, symbols are the four dimensions of the groove. Here 3 mm is the root gap and 60 degrees is the included angle of the groove. Next, let us learn combined weld symbols. Combined weld symbols are used for joints requiring more than one weld types. Here a weld symbol is used for each type of weld. In this first example here, a corner joint with a single bevel or HY weld is welded with an additional fillet weld on the other side and a backing run welded on the arrow side. In the second picture here, the symmetrical weld of single bevel T joint with additional fillet weld is welded on both sides of the welding joint. Next, let us learn the use of multiple reference line or more than one reference line in a welding symbol. More than one reference line when used show the sequence of welding operation for a welding joint. The first operation is given on the reference line nearest to the arrow always. Subsequent operations are specified sequentially on additional reference lines. Here a sequence of operations are shown for the same weld joint using three reference lines, for example. The first operation called for a backing weld on the arrow side. In the second operation, a corner single bevel weld has to be welded on the other side of the arrow. In the third operation, an additional fillet weld is welded on the other side of the arrow. The fillet weld is required to flatten is shown using a contour or finishing symbol.